a shooting at an apartment that also saw two civilians gunned down, Donnie Robichaud and Bobby Lee Wright.
So we were here this morning to charter the plane down to Fredericton to pay our respects to families and to the community of Fredericton and policing again. It's also a way of healing for our officers too as they go through this tragedy.
Association of Ontario organized a special charter flight to Fredericton, saying every officer can identify with the dangers of the job, and today's funeral is a way for first responders to find comfort in one another.
We all do the same job, and it's important for us to join together in times like this to show our respects once again to the fallen, to their families, our loved ones, and just come together as a law enforcement community.
I feel compelled to be there today to offer my condolences.
In a strong show of support for a grieving city, uniformed officers with the Fredericton Police Force were joined in a parade procession by other police agencies and RCMP before the funeral. Members of the public also lined the route. In a touching tribute, Barnes's horse Grimsby marched behind the hearses of the slain officers. Costello was a 20-year veteran of the force, a husband and a father of four. Barnes was married with three children and had been a constable for 2 years. Although the memorial service was not open to the public due to space limitations, mourners gathered at a local arena and church in Fredericton to view the funeral. Each casket was draped with a Canadian flag, and Costello's and Burns' police caps and belts. The accused in the deadly shooting spree, Matthew Vince Raymond, has been charged with 4 counts of first-degree murder.
We're inside Hugh Beach. This is one of the beaches in the city that is currently unsafe to swim in, and that's what the red flag there means. This comes after the city issued a warning this morning for residents to avoid swimming in the lake following yesterday's downpour. But the closure of this beach and 4 others only came a couple hours ago, mid this afternoon. So we asked the city for clarification. Is this beach and others like it across the city, are these beaches safe to swim in just one day after Toronto saw that heavy downpour? One day after the downpour, a tweet from the city